Atma Anatma Viveka. What is changing, what is unchanging, you have to recognize. My body is changing, my mind is changing, my intellect is changing, my thoughts are changing. But I am the unchanging reality, I am the witness of that, that recognition has to happen. That's called Nitya Anitya Viveka. Atma Anatma Viveka means I am consciousness, everything is matter. You have to differentiate between the matter and consciousness. So I can see the flower, I am aware of the flower, but flower is not aware of me. I am aware of the body, body is not aware of me. Body is Jada, I am Chaitanya. I am aware of the mind, mind is Jada or insentient, I am Chetana. Like that you have to discriminate and get established in the self. So then you recognize the self as self, I am free from everything. Body is not for me, mind is not for me, intellect is not for me. The world is not for me or not there. I am pure consciousness. At that stage, you get a clarity. I am Brahman, Shivoham, that clarity comes. Aham Brahmasmi, the clarity comes. The clarity comes, Nanu, Nanembudu, Nanalla, Ideha, Manabuddhi, Nanalla, Sachidanandatma, Shivananu Nani, Shivoham. Shivoham. So this stage is called Sattvapati. Sattva means truth. Establishment in the truth. A person who is established in the truth is called Brahmavid. Brahmavid means a knower of Brahman. One who knows himself as Brahman or pure consciousness, one who knows himself as Shiva Swarupa, is called Brahmavid. So now this Brahmavid is operating in the world. He has recognized his own self. Will he run away from the world? Not necessary. He may interact in the world, he may be like anybody, he may do social, he may do everything what is required for society. His selfish interests have gone, no more selfish interests. Everything he does out of pure, unselfish intention of contributing to society, it's called Loka Sangraha. Doing Seva, service to the world. The intentions have become purified. He may still act in the world, nobody knows he is a knower of Brahman. Nobody can recognize that person from outside. But he will continue to do the service of the world. And such a person is called Brahmavid. How does the world look like to him? How does he know himself as Brahman, consciousness? How does he see the world? For him, the world appears like more like a dream. Okay? So the world appears like a dream-like structure. This reality of the world is gone. I mean, you can imagine in dream you are running because a tiger is chasing you. Suddenly you realize that this is a dream tiger. You may continue to run, but the fear of the tiger is gone. Like that for him, the fear of the world is gone. That's called Sattvapati. So it's called first stage, or rather Brahmavid. Such a person is called Brahmavid. Then next, he moves it to next stage called Asamasakti. Asamasakti means complete total detachment. He will do perfectly everything, but he is completely detached. The best example for that is Sri Krishna Paramatma. He was involved in all aspects of life. A love and war, teaching and dancing and music. Everywhere he was there, but completely detached. The interest is not there, attachment is not there. Then why does the person behave like that? It is because of the pure prarabdha karma of that person. So his residual impressions are bringing that to him. In case of a jnani, in case of an avatar puruṣa like Sri Krishna, he has come there to establish dharma. Because of that, he behaves like that. Not because he has a desire, not because I want something, not because I need something. there is a complete detachment but enlightened action. So this is called asamasakti. It is almost like a sleep like state. So that's why Shri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Ya nisha sarva bhutana tasyam jagrati sayami. For all living beings, what is a waking state is a sleep state for a jnani, and what is waking state for a jnani is a sleep state. For all the people are sleeping to their atma, their inner self, their inner nature they have forgotten. Whereas jnani, while acting, eating, talking, walking, is fully aware of his divine nature. He is awakened to his inner nature. Then what is the world for him? World is just an appearance, a projection or maya. That is very clear. Whereas for Ajnani, the world is very real, full of attractions. For Ajnani, world is completely unreal, no attractions can capture him. And he is fully awake. So from Brahma, now we have goes to Brahma Vidvara, means a greater than Brahma Vid. Okay, now don't think, start thinking that there's a grade in that. Brahmavid, Brahmavidvara, Brahmavidvarenya, Brahmavidvareshta, there are four stages. So there is no difference in terms of jnana. There is difference in terms of behavior. Okay. So what behavior, the difference in behavior is coming because of their prarabdha karma or residual prarabdha karma, pending prarabdha karma. So all the four jnanis, Brahmavid, Brahmavidvara, Brahmavidvarenya, Brahmavidvarishta, they are all same. Internal knowledge is same, but external behavior is different. So typically, Brahma Vidvara starts withdrawing from the world unless he has a Loka Sangraha or service to the world. So he is more detached from the with respect to Brahma Vid. Padartha Abhavana. So now comes to next stage. Padartha Abhavana means the object of the world also earlier from Brahma Vid and Brahma Vidvara. They are able to see the objects of the world, perception of the, perceive the object of the world, but they are not attracted by that. Brahma Vidvarenya, now the objects also are not seen. The maya is, the screen of maya is getting lifted. So does it mean that he will walk into a wall and hit the wall? Or does it mean that he will not eat food? He will do that. But objects are not seen as objects, but they are seen as an appearance in the subject, consciousness. Okay? The subject-object duality is reduced. So now, in such a state, he becomes further separate from the society, starts moving out of the society. Possibly, if he has no, I mean, now people start coming to him, like Ramana Maharshi. Okay? So instead of he going, Brahmavidya and Brahmavidvara, they may go out to the world and do act in the Loka Sangraha. Whereas Brahmavidvarenya and Brahmavidvarishta, the Loka will come to them. They seek. So now for him, Brahmavidvarenya stage, which is called Padartha Abhavana. Padartha means object. Abhavana means absence of the object. That means the object is not there. It doesn't mean that. Object is appearing in my consciousness rather than a separate object. The subject-object duality has come down. So now finally he comes to what you call as Turyaga. Turyaga means fully awakened one. So here he is now established in the supreme reality. For him there is no object at all. There is only Brahman. Only supreme reality. What he sees is Brahman, what he hears is Brahman, what he touches is Brahman, and what he is Brahman. Other than God, nothing is there. So that is called Brahma Varishta. So Brahmavid, Brahmavara, Brahmavarenya, Brahmavarishta, these are not four stages. These are four external behaviors based on their previous pending prarabdha karma. So Brahmavid corresponds to a dream-like state. Brahma Vidvara corresponds to a sleep-like state. Brahma Vidvarenya corresponds to a deep sleep-like state. Brahma Vidvarishta corresponds to beyond our supreme reality, are fully awakened. When somebody says, I am fully awakened, the two requirements is to be met. He has to go through two understandings. First is, I am pure consciousness, free from the body, mind and intellect. It's called Aham Brahmasmi Shivoham. That clarity has to come. Second understanding has to come, Jagat Mithya, the world is unreal. Brahma Satya, consciousness alone is reality, world is unreal. That clarity has to come. If the world, a little bit of reality is also there, means Maya, a little bit of reality is also there, you get again captured by that world. So you have to become free from the concept that world is real. Brahma Satya, Jagan Mithya. I am Brahman, Aham Brahmasmi. That clarity comes. That's not the end of it. Finally, he has to recognize that world is also Brahman. Other than Brahman, there is nothing. Only absolute reality is there. So now he has become fully awakened. From a state of I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, I am the husband, I am the wife, I am engineer, I am doctor, self-identity. Now you have moved into awareness. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Surupi, Brahma Surupi. From that you have, then you have realized that the world is unreal, mithya. Brahman alone is satya, Brahma satya, Jagan mithya. And finally, there was no world and self. There was Brahman all the time. Brahman alone is the reality. So, next level of realization happens. Aham Brahma asmi to sarvam khaluida Brahma. All this is Brahman. So, this is what is called awakening. So, I told you, awakening in two stages. The stages of awakening from, one from Yoga Vashishta, called seventh Jnana Mumbikas, and also other from Panchadashi of Sri Vidyaranya called Trapti Deepika. So with that, I conclude this class, and any questions are I can answer. I'll close, conclude this. Asatoma Satgamaya Namasoma Jyotirgamaya Pratyorma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Lokaha Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Lokaha Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu.